وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، جزاك الله خيرا، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. إن شاء الله تعالى we are going to start the tafsir of Surah Al-Inshiqaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا السماء انشقت وأذنت لربها وحقت وإذا الأرض مدت وألقت ما فيها وتخلت وأذنت لربها وحقت يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهله مسرورا وأما من أوتي كتابه وراء ظهره فسوف يدعو ثبورا ويصلى سعيرا إنه كان في أهله مسرورا إنه ظن أن لن يحور بلى إن ربه كان به بصيرا فلا أقسم بالشفق والليل وما وسق والقمر إذا اتسق لتركبن طبقا عن طبق. فما لهم لا يؤمنون وإذا قرئ عليهم القرآن لا يسجدون. بل الذين كفروا يكذبون والله أعلم بما يوعون فبشرهم بعذاب أليم إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم أجر غير ممنون. سورة الانشقاق. الله سبحانه وتعالى he said إذا السماء انشقت, when the sky has split open, وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ. And it has responded to its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَحُقَّتْ. And it has every single right to do so. This surah, as we've just seen right now, is from the surah of the Qur'an. It's from the surahs in the Qur'an that a person would do a prostration in it. Abi Rafi', he said, صَلَّيْتُ مَعَ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةِ. I prayed with Abu Huraira, رضي الله تعالى. I prayed with him, صلاة العتمة. صلاة العتمة is what? عِشَى. The Prophet prohibited the عَتَمَة to be referred to as عِشَى. But the scholars, they make an explanation for it, as Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid mentions in the sharah of the kitab Ihkamu al-Ahkam, which is a sharah of Umdatul Ahkam. So Abu Huraira led Salatul Isha. فَقَرَأَ, he recited, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ فَسَجَدَ فِيهَا. Abu Huraira prostrated. فَقُلْتُ لَهُ, I said to him, مَا هَذِهِ السَّجْدَةِ. Abi Rafi' said, I said to Abu Huraira, what is this prostration that you're doing? فَقَالَ, he said, سَجَدْتُ بِهَا خَلْفَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He said, سَجَدْتُ بِهَا خَلْفَ أَبِي الْقَاسِمِ. I did this prostration behind Nabi Allah Muhammad. Nabi Allah Muhammad prostrated like this. فَلَا أَزَالُ أَسْجُدُ بِهَا. As long as I live, I will do that prostration, he said. That's why I said, everybody, do the prostration. Abu Huraira said, فَلَا أَزَالُ, I will remain prostrating, أَسْجُدُ بِهَا حَتَّى أَلْقَاهُ, until I meet Nabi Allah Muhammad. The narrator who narrated this in the narration of the hadith, or is in the chain of narration, his name is Muhammad ibn Abd al-A'la. Muhammad ibn Abd al-A'la, he said, فَلَا أَزَالُ أَسْجُدُهَا. I as well, for as long as I remain, I will also prostrate. So this sajda here is highly emphasized. It's not one that you should leave. Especially the fact that Allah says, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ, when the Qur'an is recited on them, the disbelievers, لا يسجدون, they don't prostrate to it. So the believer now doesn't let that one go. He emphasizes, or he takes it very serious in prostrating. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ. This word in the Arabic language, the word إِذَا, is a what? It's a word that's used as a conditional. When. This is called حَرْفُ شَرْط. It's a what? It's a condition. But the جَوَابُ الشَّرْط is mahduf. The response to this is hidden. Meaning, when the sky splits, what? The response is hidden. And this is what the scholars of grammar called Babu al-Ishtighal. Meaning, the term that's hidden is actually in the verse, which is إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ. And in the Arabic language, is not allowed that the harfu shart and the jawabu shart are right next to each other. There has to be, the fi'lu shart has to be in between them. It has to be in between them. And we don't have it here. We have إِذَا السَّمَاءُ شَقَّتْ, we have here. So they said that it means إِذَا السَّمَاءُ شَقَّتْ here means, it means إِذَا انشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ. If the sky splits, then it will definitely split properly. That's what it means. وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا. The word وَأَذِنَتْ in the Arabic language, it means تَصَدَّعَتْ وَأَطَاعَتْ. The word أَذِنَتْ means when the sky listens to its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it submits to it, and it takes the command of its Lord. Then the word أَذِنَتْ means تَصَدَّعَتْ وَتَقَطَّعَتْ وَسَمِعَتْ وَأَطَاعَتْ. It breaks and splits into, but it listens and it obeys its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَحُقَّتْ, what does it mean? وَحُقَّتْ, it means فَهِيَ أَهْلٌ لِهَذِهِ الطَّاعَةِ. It has every right to obey its Lord. Because Allah, it has every right to split. Because his Lord, Allah is the one who's commanded it. وَحُقَّتْ means the sky has every right to split. Why? Because Allah commanded it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word وَأَذِنَتْ is used in the Qur'an as what? Listened. That's why we said وَأَذِنَتْ, the sky listened to its Lord and it obeyed it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you all know the ayah ومنهم الذين يؤذون النبي ويقولون هو أذن. أي سمع. They're saying that the Prophet ﷺ listens to everything everybody tells him. هو أذن means here, أي the Prophet listens to everybody who speaks. And the famous hadith Abu Huraira narrated, which is in Sahih al-Bukhari, where the Prophet said, مَا أَذِنَ اللَّهُ لِشَيْءٍ. Allah is not more listening to, meaning Allah listens most to. مَا أَذِنَ اللَّهُ here means what? The thing that Allah listens the most to, subhanahu wa ta'ala, greatest, is حَسَنُ الصَّوْتِ, a beautiful recitation, بِالْقُرْآنِ يَجْهَرُ بِهِ, in which a prophet recites with a beautiful voice, and he reads it loud. This is the thing Allah listens most to, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the word that's used here is what? أَذِنَ is used. So this here, it means وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا, أي وَأَطَاعَتْ أَمْرَ رَبِّهَا. The sky obeys its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, ponder here now. If the sky, this big, this great, when Allah commanded to split, and the sky listened to its Lord, and it obeyed its Lord with all the power and all the strength that it holds, then we have a small, we're a human who's small, who's weak, and we are told to do things, and we are commanded to come with things, and what do?
There's a car, R059, broken, a female, and she can't even get out.
Tafsir, kaska dia, kaska joke tu. Hey, there's a RO?
RO59
is blocking
Astra.
Somebody.
Vauxhall Astra.
I said at the beginning, if your car's blocking somebody, just move it, inshallah ta'ala. These people, they don't look like they've got causes, huh? وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ. And it listened and obeyed its Lord, وَحُقَّتْ, and it has every right to obey. وَحُقَّ لَهَا أَن تُطِيعَ أَمْرَ رَبِّهَا. That's what it means. وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ. And the sky, مُدَّتْ means it's expanded. وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ, and when the earth, مُدَّتْ is expanded. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala expands this earth. وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا, and the earth brings out, spits out everything that is in it. The sky is going to what? Sorry, the earth is going to spit out. وَأَلْقَتْ, it throws out, it brings out. مَا فِيهَا, that which is in it. وَتَخَلَّتْ, and the earth becomes empty. This earth is going to spit out everything in it. It's going to spit out. The humans that are in it are going to come out. And also what's going to come out from it is the treasures, the gold and the silvers are going to come out. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us in a hadith, and Imam Muslim narrated in Sahih, min hadith Abi Huraira, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam, he told us, taqi'u al-ardu, this earth is going to vomit. The Prophet said this. He said, taqi'u al-ardu, this earth is going to vomit. And what is it going to vomit? أفلاد كبدها أمثال الأسطوان من الذهب والفضة. The earth will vomit long pieces of its livers. They are like columns. It's going to spit it all out. من الذهب والفضة. Gold is going to come out of this earth. والفضة. Silver. This earth is going to spit it out and vomit it out. فيجيء القاتل. The killer, the murderer will go by. He sees gold on the floor. He's going to see silver on the floor, the murderer that day. And he's going to look at it. And he will look at the gold and the silver and he would say, "Fi hada qataltu." Due to you, I killed people. Silver, gold, it was through you I killed people. وَيَجِيءُ الْقَاطِعُ, the one who cut the ties of kinship and left his family behind and walked away from them and left them because of dunya and money making. He will look at the gold. And he will say, and the silver on the earth, just spat it all out. He will say, "Fi hada qata'tu," due to you, I cut rahimi, my ties of kinship, my family, my mom, my dad. I left them in Africa to die because I was making some money in the UK. I left my parents in Africa or in Asia. I left them. I don't pick up their phone when they call me. وَيَجِيءُ السَّارِقُ, the thief will also go by the gold and the silver, and he will say, "Fi hada qut'at yadi," Because of you, my hand was cut. It's because of you. ثُمَّ يَدَعُونَهُ Each and every one of them will look at it and they will walk away from it. No one will touch the gold and no one will touch the silver. None of them. فَلَا يَأْخُذُونَ مِنْهُ شَيْءٍ And the Prophet said, none of them will take anything from it. Because it means nothing today. Silver doesn't mean anything. Gold does not mean anything. That day everybody's concern is, what is your deeds? Then the earth will spit out everything. وَأَلْقَتْ مَا فِيهَا The earth will vomit everything that is in it. وَتَخَلَّتْ Nothing's going to be there. Nothing's going to be there. وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here says, وَأَذِنَتْ The earth listens to its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَحُقَّتْ And it has every right to listen to its Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we said, وَأَذِنَتْ Has been repeated how many times? Twice. The first time when it was said, and the second time when it was said, is it the same? Memorize one qa'idah. Al-aslu fil kalami ta'sis. That the asal of speech and the original matter of speech is that it gives you a new meaning. Duna tawkeed. And it doesn't give you any emphasis. The asal of speech, when somebody says something, the asal is that their speech is going to give you new meaning. And it's not that they give you what? A repetition of what they already mentioned. Okay? And this ayah, وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ has been repeated twice. The first time when it was mentioned, it was talking about the what? The sama'. The sama' has every right to what? To split and to crack. The second time, وَأَذِنَتْ لِرَبِّهَا وَحُقَّتْ is mentioned, is talking about what? It's talking about the earth. The earth is going to expand. And the earth is going to spit out everything in it. It's going to vomit everything out. It has every right to do so. It has every right to do so. يا أيها الإنسان الله سبحانه وتعالى he then says يا أيها الإنسان O mankind إنك كادح You are laboring. You are working hard. The word كادح in the Arabic language it means العمل والكسب. The word الكادح means what? Al-amal working. Every one of us on this earth are what? Each and every one of us on this earth are what? We're working. Every one of us. Ya ayyuha al-insanu, O mankind, innaka kadihun, you are laboring, you are working, ila rabbika, to your Lord, kadhan, exerted laboring. Extra effort you're putting in. Famula'aqi. What does it mean? فَمُلَاقِيهِ What does it actually mean? It means you're going to see and you're going to come in contact with it. What is it that you're going to meet? Is it that you're going to meet Allah? Or does it mean that you're going to meet the actions that you put forward? It means both of them. Because if you meet Allah, what are you going to meet with Allah? Your deeds and the actions that you put forward. This ayah shows us that every single person is laboring. Everybody here is working. Because Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say? Ya ayyuha al-insan, O mankind, Allah is talking to all mankind. Innaka kadihun, you are laboring towards your Lord. Some are doing righteous deeds. Some are working hard. Some are putting effort in. Some, their deeds and their actions are excessive righteousness. At night they are waking up. They're praying. At daytime that they're fasting. And another group of people, they are working, but they're working corruption and harm, and they're trying to extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then everybody's working. So Allah is going to tell us in the ayah to come next, the two types of people who are working here. Those who labored and they put work in, but their work was good. Allah is going to tell us what they're going to receive. And Allah then is going to tell us again, the ones who are working, but their working was towards shar and evil. May Allah protect us from it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah starts with the first of the Ahlul Kadhi. The first of who? Ahlul Kadhi. The first people of those who are working in good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with them. He says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ Then as for he who is given his record, his book is being given to him. بيمينه is given to him with the right. Is given to him in his right hand. فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. He will be judged, this individual, and the judgment for him will be with ease. فَسَوْفَ, he would be judged and accounted. يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا, an accounting, which is what? يَسِيرًا. يَسِيرًا means easy. Simple accounting is what's going to be given to him. This one is the one who's laboring and his hard work and his effort was what? بِالْخَيْرِ. He was doing good. He was working hard. That's what's going to be done to this one. فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا وَيَنْقَلِبُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ. And he will turn back to his family, his people. مَسْرُورًا, in a state of happiness. He's going to go back to his wife in Jannah. The Mufassirin they mention, like Qatada, he said that, من طريق السعيد, he said, إِلَىٰ أَهْلٍ أَعَدَّهُمُ اللَّهُ لَهُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. The family that he's going to go to are a family who Allah has made for him in Jannah. It could be one of two. It could be his wife, his spouse that he had in his dunya, who worked hard with him, who's now made it to Jannah with him. Or it could be a wife, her husband has worked hard as well, he has made it to Jannah with her. Or it could be women who have been prepared for him in Jannah. It could be any of the two. This ayah, أشكلت أمنا عائشة. This ayah, it became ambiguous and unclear to our mother Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. It became unclear to our mother Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated on the authority of Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها. قالت, she heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one time say, من نوقش عذب. The Prophet ﷺ said, anybody who is accounted is punished. Anyone who is accounted is what? Is punished. مَنْ نُوقِشَ, anybody who is accounted, who is questioned, who is interrogated, عُذِبَ, he is punished. It's a punishment. When the Prophet said that, our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said to the Prophet, أَلَيْسَ قَالَ اللَّهُ. Is it not that Allah said, أَلَيْسَ قَالَ اللَّهُ, did Allah not say? And she recited this ayah, فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. When she read this ayah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Aisha, لَيْسَ دَاكَ بِالْحِسَابِ. This ayah, فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا, is not. Because what did the Prophet say? مَنْ نُوقِشَ عُذِبْ. Anybody who's interrogated, anybody who is questioned is what? Is punished, right? And this ayah is saying that they're going to be interrogated, a good and easy interrogation. Or they're going to be accounted, an accounting which is easy. And the Prophet here is saying, anybody who's accounted or anybody who's interrogated is what? Is punished. So she said, how can we reconcile between your statement here and the ayah? The Prophet then said to Aisha, فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. It's not accountability, these people. This is what then? وَلَكِنْ ذَلِكَ الْعَرْضِ. This is the presentation. What does that mean? Well, what does the Prophet mean by that? The Day of Judgment, Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, مِنْ حَدِيثِ ابْنُ عُمَرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُمَا, that the Prophet said, يُدْنَى الْمُؤْمِنُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. The believer will be brought close the Day of Judgment. He'll be brought close. مِنْ رَبِّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, to his Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَتَّى يَضَعَ عَلَيْهِ كَنَفَهُ. Until Allah tabarak wa ta'ala places over him his veil. فَيُقَرِّرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then bring to him his sins, his shortcomings, his errors, his faults. Allah will bring them to him. فَيُقَرِّرُهُ. Allah will establish it to him. بِذُنُوبِهِ, his shortcomings and the mistakes that he's come with. فَيَقُولُ, it will be said to him, هَلْ تَعْرِفُ, do you recognize this? Do you know this? Do you know this sin that you've done? فَيَقُولُ, he will say, إِن رَبِّي, نَعَمْ, my Lord. Of course, oh Allah, I know it. أَعْرِفُ, I recognize this. I know when I did this. And then Allah, تبارك وتعالى, he says to him, قَدْ سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا.
when you were in this world, I concealed it and I hid this sin for you. Meaning the people didn't know. They saw you to be a good brother, a practicing brother, a brother who's upright, a brother who's steadfast, with knowing that you were doing this sin and no one else knew it. Only I knew it and you. I made sure no one knew that sin of yours. It was hidden for you. It was concealed for you. قَدْ سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا. I made sure no one knows about it in dunya for you. وَإِنِّي أَغْفِرُهَا لَكَ الْيَوْمِ. And today, I'm going to forgive you for it. I'm going to what? Forgive you for it. فَيُعْطَى. He will be given صَحِيفَةَ حَسَنَاتِ. He will be given the scrolls in which his righteous deeds are written on it. وَأَمَّا الْكَافِرُ. As for the disbelievers. وَالْمُنَافِقُونَ. The hypocrites who pretend to be Muslims. فَيُنَادَى بِهِمْ عَلَى رُؤُسِ الْخَلَائِقِ. Those ones are going to be called out in front of everybody. They're going to be called out. And it will be said to them, هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ. These are the ones who lied upon their Lord. They will be exposed. Their sins and their shortcomings will be mentioned out and in public. Everybody will know what they did wrong. They will be exposed for that, and their reality will be brought out. They will be exposed. The munafiqeen and the kuffar. So this individual is the one that the Prophet is talking about. فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. Because the way that his sins will be brought to him and his shortcomings will be brought to him is what? Is مُجَرَّدِ الْعَرْضِ. It's just presentation. It will be presented to him. But he won't be accounted for it. He won't be asked, why did you do this? What made you do this? The one that is being done to is the disbeliever and the criminals and those who Allah wants to punish them. مَنْ نُوقِشَ عُذِبْ. That's what the Prophet means, alayhi salatu wasalam. That anybody who's interrogated, he's asked, why did you do this? Because the person doesn't have an answer. That question itself is going to hurt him. As for this one, in the dunya, he was seen as a good person. That day when he leaves his Lord, he was taken away from the rest of the people. Allah placed a veil between him and the people. Allah placed a veil. No one could see him. Allah talks to him. Then Allah tells him, now you can go. The people look at him as though he's never done a sin. They believe he didn't do anything wrong. Who only knows that he did a sin that day? Only him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this, what we realize is that Allah is the only one who would know his slave do a sin and hide it for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More merciful to you than your mother is to you. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ. Those who their book is being given to them on the right hand are the ones فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. The accountability for those ones, it will be for them easy. وَيَنْقَلِبُ. And they, those individuals, they will turn back إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ. To their families. مَسْرُورًا. They are excessively happy. They are what? They are excessively happy of the news that has been given to them. They will be very happy. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ. And as for the one who these book will be given to him, his record will be given to him, وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. From behind his back. It will be given to him. Behind his back it will be given to him. فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا. That one, he will cry out for destruction. He will say, oh, destruction be upon me. He will call out for destruction. فَسَوْفَ. This one will... فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا. This one will call out for ثُبُورًا, destruction. ثُبُور means what? A halak. He will call for halak. As Dahak said, يَدْعُو بِالْهَلَاك. He will call out for destruction. وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا. And he will enter to burn into the hellfire. This ayah, from the Zahir, as it may seem to many of us, it seems that it might be contradicting another verse. This ayah tells us, it seems, that it might be contradicting another verse. And as we know, this Qur'an does not in its reality oppose each other, or does not contradict. As Allah said in the Qur'an, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Why do you not ponder over the Qur'an? For if this Qur'an was to come to you from anyone other than Allah, you would find what? You'll find contradictions in it. And then this means the fact that the Quran is from Allah, there is not going to be any contradiction. What is it that seems to be a contradiction is that in Surah Al-Haqa, Allah says, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ. As for the one who his book will be given to him on the left hand. And this ayah is saying that وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. As for the one whose book is going to be given to him from behind his back. So how do you reconcile between he will be given to him on his left hand and he will be given to him from behind? Does anyone have the... Can anyone try to... Hey?
His left hand will be behind his back.
His left hand will be behind his back. Hey, yeah? Any other qawl? Na'am. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Imam al-Mufassirin, he says, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُعْطِيَ كِتَابَهُ مِنْكُمْ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ وَذَلِكَ بِأَنْ جَعَلَ يَدَهُ الْيُمْنَى عَلَى عُنُقِهِ وَجَعَلَ الشِّمَالَ مِنْ يَدَيْهِ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ. The right hand is going to be placed on his neck like that, and the left hand will be placed behind his back like that. Behind his back. And so when his left hand is behind his back, the left is behind his back, is it being given to him on the left or behind his back? Both. Because his left hand is what? It's behind his back. That's why Ibn Jarir then says, فَيَتَنَاوَلُ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ مِنْ وَرَاءِ ظَهْرِي وَلِذَلِكَ وَصَفَهُمْ جَلَّ ثَنَاؤُهُ أَحْيَانًا أَنَّهُمْ يُؤْتُونَ كُتُبَهُمْ بِشِمَالِهِمْ وَأَحْيَانًا أَنَّهُمْ يُؤْتُونَهَا مِنْ وَرَاءِ ظَهُورِهِمْ. That's what Allah mentioned. Sometimes the book will be given to them, what? On their left. And sometimes He mentioned it will be given to them, what? Behind their backs. So they will be tied, the disbelievers. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ. And as for who he, those disbelievers, whose record will be given to them, مِنْ وَرَى مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِي, from behind. فَسَوْفَ, they will call out, they will scream, and they will say, only destruction come to us. فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا, and they will enter to burn in a blaze, the hellfire. That's the second type of the people of Ahlul Kadhi. Ahlul Kadhi, how many? The people who are working and exerting so much effort in are those who are working towards what? خَيْرًا كَانَ أَمْ شَرًّا. Some people are working towards good and some are working towards evil. The ones who are working towards good, what is it that Allah is going to give them? Their books on the what? On their right hands. And how is their accountability going to be? It's going to be very easy for them. And they're going to go back to their families what? Happy. They're going to go back to their family happy. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us a very powerful thing, which is, He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. Allah is telling us the disbelievers, the munafiqeen, and also the Muslims who are also being punished here. Allah tells us, أَنَّهُ كَانَ فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا, أَنَّهُ كَانَ, that this individual who was given his book behind his back, he was in the dunya and he was with his family, he was what? Fi ahli masrura, he was happy. In the dunya, he was laughing and he was happy. This is the opposite to what? The believers. The believers, are they happy and they're laughing? Or are they concerned and they're worried? Allah tells us in Surah Tur. It's going to come to us in Surah Tur. Inshallah ta'ala. Allah says, وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَسَأَلُونَ قَالُوا إِنَّا كُنَّا قبل في أهلنا مشفقين فمن الله علينا ووقعنا عذاب السموم. إنا كنا قبل, we were before, when we were in the dunya, إنا كنا قبل في أهلنا مشفقين, when we were with our family we were مشفق. مشفق means what? Like خائفين. In the dunya we were scared and we were worried about the عذاب and what waits us on the other side. فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Because of that fear that we came with and that worry that was on our heart all the time, what did Allah do? فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah bestowed His mercy upon us. وَوَقَانَا عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ. And Allah protected us from the what? The punishment of the hellfire. And then the believer in this dunya, he's khaif, he's scared and he's worried. As for the disbelievers, they're laughing, they're joking. Everything is a joke for them. That's what Allah says, إِنَّهُ كَانَ. This individual who his book has been given to him, وَرَأَ ظَهْرِ, from behind, he was what? فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. He's what? فِي أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. He's one who is amongst his people, he is in happiness. Then Allah says, إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ. He thought, this individual, he thought and assumed. The word ظَنَّ sometimes comes as yaqeen in the Quran, and sometimes it comes as what? Speculation and assumption. إِنَّهُ ظَنَّ. He has assumed, this individual, and he started to what? Have the belief, أَلَّنْ يَحُور, that he's not going to return to Allah. يَحُور means what? يَحُور means to turn back to. He believed, he started to have the concept and the belief that he's not going to come back to Allah. The way he's acting and the way he is, he lives a life that he believes that he's not going to come back to Allah. He lives that kind of life. أَنَّهُ ظَنَّ أَلَّنْ يَحُور, that he's not going to return back to his Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to account him for what he has said and done. So in the dunya, he's laughing. What is it that he's laughing about? What is it he's happy about? He's happy about his sins. No kana fi ahlihi. He was with his family, masrura. A masrur on what? The ma'asi, the sins that he's doing. He's laughing, he's enjoying himself. Do you know what I did yesterday? Do you know what I said to that girl yesterday? Do you know how I act? This is what he says to himself. And then Allah tells us, أَنَّهُ ظَنَّ, he assumed and started to believe, أَلَّنْ يَحُورَ, that he is not going to what? Come back to Allah, and that Allah is not going to account him for what he said and did. بَلَى, let alone him being returned to Allah, and let alone him being accounted for what he did. Of course he would. إِنَّ رَبَّهُ, his Lord, كَانَ بِهِ بَصِيرًا. His Lord Allah, let alone him bringing him the Day of Judgment and accounting him, he would do that. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one who is basir. He's seeing over him. Seeing over who? This individual, what he's doing. The sins that he's coming with. The ma'asi that he's doing. وَلَا يُبَالِي, and he doesn't care how he's doing it and how he's falling into it. This individual, Allah is muttali'un. Allah is what? كَانَ اللَّهُ مُطَّلِعًا عَلَيْهَا. Allah is one who's really observing over his sins. And his shortcomings, and he's aware of it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. The word فَلَا, the word لَا, whenever you hear فَلَا أُقْسِمُ, Surah Al-Buruj, لَا أُقْسِمُ بِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, the لَا here is not nafi. Okay, underline that, memorize that. It's not negation, it's not nafi. It's tawkeed, it's emphasis. Nothing's been negated here. It's tawkeedun wa laysa binafiyin. It's tawkeed, it's emphasis, and it's not negation. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ, Allah is saying, I swear by the بِالشَّفَقِ, I swear by the shafaq. What does the shafaq mean? Shafaq means, it means حُمْرَةِ الْأُفُقِ. In English it's called twilight, right? Twilight. Allah is saying, I swear by the twilight when it's red. Is it the sunset when before Maghrib time? It's Maghrib time. Allah is saying, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. Shafaq meaning Maghrib. There's a hadith narrated by Al Imam al Bukhari in his Sahih, min hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, alayhi salatu wasalam, and this wording, this hadith, sorry, is narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, min hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. That the Prophet said, وَوَقْتُ صَلَاةِ الْمَغْرِبِ. Abdullah ibn Amr al-As said that the timing of Maghrib is مَا لَمْ يَغِبِ الشَّفَقْ, as long as the shafaq does not go. Maghrib is when? Before the twilight sets. That's what Maghrib is. If it goes, then salah time goes. فَلَا أُقَسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ. Allah said, I swear by that time. وَاللَّيْلِ, and I swear by the night. وَمَا وَسَقَ. وَسَقَ means envelope. What it in Arabic language, the word wasaqa means a ijtama'a. Amajama'a. What the night gathers and what the night brings together. The night, what does it bring together? The shayateen and the jinn and the humans and everything is walking on this earth. That's why the Prophet said, at night, don't leave your what? Cups. Huh? Not covered. You cover everything in the house. You don't sleep with cups, mouths open. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Wal-layli, and the night. Wa ma wasaqa. Allah swears by the night and what it envelopes, a jama'ah. Wal-qamari, Allah then swears by subhanahu wa ta'ala. Idha tasaqa, Allah he swears by the moon when it becomes full. When it becomes full. He swore by that subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where's the Jawabul Qasam? The Jawabul Qasam, what's the response to that? All of that Allah is swearing by. There's an oath Allah is making. He's swearing by the what? The Shafaq. Allah is swearing also by the what? Wal-layli wa ma wasaq. Allah is also swearing by what? Wal-qamari idha tasaq. Wal-qamari idha tasaq means what? When the moon is full. That's on the 13th night, sah? Taqriban. It's a full moon. There is four aqwal of the mufassirin. Four qawl has come regarding wa ma wasaq. There's no need to mention the four qawl. Like in the four qawl are ikhtilafu tanawwu'. It's all khilaf of what? It's khilaf in terms of wording. One qawl says istawa, when it equals. Again, it means when it's a full moon. The second one, idha jtama'a wa mtala. They use idha tasaq, because tasaq comes from wasaqa. Wasaqa means jama'a. When the moon's edges come together, it becomes complete and it comes together in envelopes. And then that's a full moon again. Some of the mufassirin, they said, لِثَلَاثَةِ عَشَرٍ, when it reaches the 13th night. Again, that's a full moon. And the fourth one is, إِذَا اسْتَدَارَ, when it becomes round. And then that means, it's a full moon. All of those are what? خِلَافٌ مِنْ قَبِيلِ. This اختلاف is مِنْ قَبِيلِ اختلافِ التَّنَوُّعِ. It's خِلَاف, which is difference of wording, but the meaning is what? It's all the meaning the same. All of those aqwal are brought from Ibn Abbas, Dhahhak, Ikrima, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, Mujahid ibn Jabrin, and others. They've said Hassan al-Basri and others, Qatada, all of them. Allah then says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, here's the Jawab al-Qasam for all of that. The oath that Allah made here, that he swore by the twilight, and that he swore by the moon, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the full moon, and that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he swore by the night. Here's the answer to that. By all that which he swore, لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ, that you all will surely experience state after state. Here the Mufassirin differed. They questioned, okay, we're going to experience state after state. Because this description of state after state is a wasf, it's a description. And this is wasf. It's, as they call it, wasf, which is muhtamal. What does a wasf muhtamal mean? It's a description that can possibly take many things. How many things go through state after state? So what is it that we're going to experience, which is state after state? The aqwal became much. I'm going to mention some of those qawl. First of all, latarkabanna is one qira'ah. And another qira'ah is what? Latarkabunna. One qira'ah is what? Latarkabunna. Bi what? Dhammil ba'i. Placing a dhamma on the ba'. So you say latarkabunna. Another qira'ah is what? And they are qira'atani mutawatiratani. They are two qira'ah which have reached multitude narration. The second qira'ah is what? Latarkabanna. Latarkabunna. That is what the ayah is right now. And the meaning to that is that you, O mankind. Because Allah was talking about before, Ya ayyuhan nas, sah. So Allah is talking to who? All of us, mankind. That we're going to go through what? We're going to go through stages. And the stages that we're going to go through is that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he started us off as a nutfa. We started off as a nutfa. What's a nutfa? Huh? A sperm drop, right? Huh? We started off as that. In the womb of our mothers. And then we turned out to be what after that? we became alaqa. Alaqa is what? A clot. Blood clot. And then we became a mudghah. Mudghah is a piece of meat now. And then we started to get bones and we started to get created. And we went through stages after stages. As the Prophet said in the hadith, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ يُجْمَعُ خَلْقُهُ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ يَوْمًا نُطْفَةً ثُمَّ يَكُونُ عَلَقَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ ثُمَّ يَكُونُ مُضْغَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ ثُمَّ يُرْسَلُ إِلَيْهِ مَلَكٌ فَيُنْفَخُ فِيهِ الرُّوحُ وَيُؤْمَرُ بِأَرْبَعِ كَلِمَاتٍ بِكَتْبِ رِزْقِهِ وَأَجَلِهِ وَعَمَلِهِ شَقِيٌّ أَوْ سَعِيدٌ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. Hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. That the person goes through those stages. That's if we recite the ayah as what? لَتَرْكَبُنَّ. That is talking to mankind. But if we say latarkabanna and we read it as a fatha on the ba, then this is, means that it is addressing somebody, it's talking to somebody, a particular person. Latarkabanna, you will go you will surely go through stages after stages. So who's the person who's being addressed here? They differed amongst themselves. Some said, no, it's still the humans that are being addressed. That's one qawl. Another qawl is that, no, it's referring to who? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. It's talking to him. And if it's talking to him, then what is it telling him that we don't share with him? They said what it means is that, oh, you Muhammad, you're going to go to, and you're going to go surely go through and experience stages after stages, meaning sama', and after another sama', after another sama', and this is referring to the night of Isra wal Mi'raj. That's what some scholars said. Another group of scholars, they said, la, it falls under kaqawlihi ta'ala, iyaka a'ni wasma' ya jara. Nabi Muhammad's being spoken to here, but it means everybody else. He's been spoken to, but it's not specific to him. It's actually talking to everybody else. And some of the scholars actually said, لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ. It means that we are surely going to experience stages after stages, as in the famous hadith, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ السَّنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. That we are going to follow the footsteps of the Yahud and the Nasara. Shibran bi shibr, wa dhira'an bi dhira'. Hatta law dakhalu juhra dhabbin la dakhaltumuh. The Prophet ﷺ said that we what? We're going to what? Follow shibran bi shibr. Shibran bi shibr means what? Huh. It's like this. Wa dhira'an bi dhira' is what? Arm. Hatta law dakhalu juhra Dabbin, to the extent that if you enter what? Why did the Prophet choose to use the word lizard? The lizard's the only animal that never recognizes its house. It moves away from it. When it looks back, it doesn't know where it came out from. In other words, the lizard is a confused animal that doesn't know where it came out from. The believers are going to be like that. They're going to go in somebody else's hole. The lizard goes into a hole that's not his. And it comes running out. Huh? And that's how the believers are going to be. They're going to leave what was theirs and their religion and their deen and a path that was set for them. And they're going to go to holes and other things and other people's way of life. So the believers are going to be like that. لَتَرْكَبُنَّ, Allah says, طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ. You will surely experience state after state. Allah then says, فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is istifamun inkarik, as it's wadih, it's clear. Allah then says, فَمَا لَهُمْ. Why is it not? Why are these people? I mean, why is it not the matter that they do not believe? فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Why is it that they don't believe? The reason why Allah is asking this question is, why don't they affirm the resurrection? After they have clearly seen the hujjah and the proofs have been placed in front of them, Allah put us through stages after stages. Allah is the one who brought you from a nutfa, and then He made you into a alaqa, and then He made you into a mudgha, and then He made you into a human that you are today, and then you grow old, and then you go to your grave. The one who has put you through those cycles, is it very hard for Him to bring you back to how you were? He made you when you were nothing. If something is complicated, then it would be more complicated to make something from nothing. Nothing is complicated to Him. Would it be hard for Him to bring you back to how you were? Allah then said, فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Why is it that these people are not believing? وَلِذَلِكَ, the issue is, brothers, some people, the proofs and the evidences just make matters even more harder for them to believe. The evidences and the proofs are never going to enter their hearts. As Allah said in the Qur'an, أولئك الذين لم يرد الله. These are people Allah has not wanted أن يطهر قلوبهم. Allah did not want to purify their hearts. These are people Allah did not want to guide them. Some people Allah just never wants to guide them. In this dunya they have what? They have a khizy in this dunya. They're going to live a very hard life. And what awaits them in the hereafter is far greater. Some people, it just does not come to them to give up and to surrender to the truth when it's brought to them. Every ayah that is brought to them, it makes them even more stubborn and even more hard-headed. Sheikh Al-Albani used to say, a person who one evidence doesn't convince them, 1,000 will not. Anyone who says to you, after you've given him an ayah, he says to you, okay, give me another ayah. If you couldn't take an ayah, if you couldn't take a hadith, if you couldn't take one evidence, what makes you think they're going to take 100 if it's brought to you? So the believer, he believes what evidence are brought to him, and he takes them. And he hears and he obeys and he submits to them. Allah says, فَمَا لَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Why are these not? I mean, what is the matter with these individuals? That they don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَدْ عَيَنُوا الْحُجَجِ. The proofs, they've looked at it, Ibn Jarir says. Evidences have been brought to their attention. Everything. This is قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ الرَّسُولُ قَالَ اللَّهُ. They'll say to my sheikh, said this, but it's simple. My sheikh is not of that opinion. يَا أَخِي أَقُولُ لَكَ قَالَ اللَّهُ. I'm saying to Allah said. I'm saying to you, the messenger said. And you're saying to me, your sheikh said. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقُرْآنُ. If the Qur'an is recited on them, and it's read on them, لَا يَسْجُدُونَ. They don't prostrate. They don't prostrate as in, لَا يَخْضَعُونَ. They don't humble themselves and put their heads down in submission to what the Qur'an is telling them. They don't do that, تَعَظِيمًا وَاحْتِرَامًا لَهُ. They don't do that in honoring and venerating the Qur'an. They don't do that. They're arrogant and stubborn and hard-headed. This is the most powerful work, the most powerful speech, sorry, that has been what? That has been recited on them. Verses have been read on them. مَعَ ذَلِكَ. They don't humble themselves. لَا يَخْضَعُونَ فَيَسْجُدُونَ. They don't humble themselves and prostrate. لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى. To Allah, تَعَظِيمًا وَاحْتَرَامًا. In honoring Him and venerating Him. And this ayah, brothers, is the ayah that when you recite in surah, you what? You prostrate. Does anyone else know which other surahs in the Quran, put your hand up, that prostration is done? Second question is that, but there is a prophetic evidence for that. It's dalil for it. So you have to mention the evidence with it, and where you've, what book it's written in, and if it's, and where it is. This is the book of Allah. How much is it, first of all, that has evidences, and where is the evidences? Fadbal. Surah Al-Najm. Hey, where, what's the evidence for that one? Anyone who mentions the evidence, he has to give us, he mentions something, he has to give us the evidence for it. Sahih, ikhwa, nahnul, the people of Dalil. You can't say I saw it on the Mus'haf. It's not enough, is it? You have an evidence. When you say this place, you have evidence. Fadal.
Surah
Sajdah. Surah Sajdah, yeah? Na'am. So Surah Sajdah is that the Prophet ﷺ led the Salah and he prostrated alayhi salatu wasalam. What Salah was he leading? He led it on Friday. Where is it narrated in? I think it's in. Yeah, who agrees with that qawl? My humble opinion. I read Bukhari from beginning to end. I don't remember a hadith like that. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did lead Salatul Sajda on Fridays. The fact that he prostrated in Sahih al-Bukhari, fihi nazar. There's a look to that. That needs to be. Not one person here can put their hand up and say that this is the evidence for one of the sajdas in the Quran. It's a good homework, right? Take it now, inshallah. No one's going to do the homework if I give it. The first one is this surah that we took today. Where did I say it was narrated? Yeah? The surah, this surah, surah that we're in, Surah Al-Shiqaq. Where did I say it was narrated in? Huh? I said it was in Sahih Muslim. Who narrated it? Abu Huraira. Who is the person who asked Abu Huraira? Yeah? Abu Rafi, he asked, right? Who is the person who said, I also will prostrate as long as I live? Yeah? No. Yeah? Muhammad ibn Abdul A'la. Ibn Abdul A'la, now. He said, Ma azalu asjud. As long as I live, I will remain to prostrate. Good. The next one is Surah al-Najm. Surah al-Najm, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in the Sahih. On the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that he said, قرأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he read al-Najm in Mecca. The Prophet read Surah al-Najm in Mecca. فسجد فيها, the Prophet prostrated in it. وسجد معه, and also prostrated with him غير شيخ, other than one sheikh, other than one person. All the elderly people were there, they prostrated with him عليه الصلاة والسلام. Those who couldn't even prostrate, who were old, they took dust from the earth and they placed it on their foreheads. They did that عليه الصلاة والسلام. The third one is Surah Al-Sad. Bukhari narrated min hadithi min tariq al-Awwam radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, سألت مجاهدا. Al-Awwam, he said, I asked Mujahid ibn Jabrin. I asked him عن سجدة الصاد. I asked him about the prostration of Surah Al-Sad. I said, what is it? Mujahid said to Al-Awwam, he said to him, سألت, he said, I asked before you to Ibn Abbas. Just like you're asking me now, I also asked Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, min ayna sajadta, where did you prostrate? And then he recited for him. Does anyone know what he recited from him? Where's the sajda in Surah Sad? Huh? Second page is not enough. Huh? Does anyone know? Huh? Huh? It's around those areas. We mean Dawood, from the story of Nabiullah, Dawood, when Dawood alayhi salatu salam comes into the story, that prostration was actually legislated, as this hadith mentions, because the story starts from Amin Dhurriyati Dawood or Sulaiman. From that onwards, Nabiullah Dawood prostrates. The narration says, فَكَانَ Dawood مِنْ مَنْ أُمِرَ نَبِيُّكُمْ. It was Dawood through him that it was commanded for our Prophet to prostrate. And he was commanded to what? Follow Nabiullah Dawood. فَسَجَدَ Dawood, he prostrated, so did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The last one is Surah Al-Alaq. The last one is what? Surah Al-Alaq. Muslim narrated in Sahih min hadithi Abi Huraira, he said, سَجَدْنَا مَعَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Abu Huraira said, we prostrated with the Prophet, we prostrated with him, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ, and we prostrated with him, اِقْرَأْ بِاسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقْ. Those are the sajadat that are in the Quran. Sorry, those are the sajadat التي ثبت بالسند الصحيح عن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سجد فيها. Those are the sajadat that we authentically have asanid sahih that the Prophet prostrated them. Those are the ones we have. Anything other than that is موضوع الخلاف and discussions on it. But these are hadith ثابت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, بل كذبوا, rather they disbelieved. The disbelievers, they disbelieved. بل الذين كفروا, the disbelievers, the kuffar, they denied. يكذبون, they denied. والله أعلم, and Allah تبارك وتعالى is most knowing of what? بما يوعون. Allah is one who is most knowing of what they keep within within themselves. Allah يوعون means what? Allah تبارك وتعالى, he knows. عالم بما تحويه. Allah is one who is knowledgeable, who is aware of that which تحويه صدورهم, that which is within their chests. وَتُخْفِيهِ And that which they are hiding, من التكذيب, the denial that is in their hearts. بكتاب الله, in the book of Allah, ورسوله, and his messenger. Some of the disbelievers will come up to you and they will say to you, I don't believe Islam and I don't disbelieve in Islam. Some of them, they will say that to you. But Allah knows if what they are saying is true or the denial and the takdeeb that's in their hearts. He knows that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَبَشِّرْهُمْ Allah says, oh Muhammad, give them glad tidings. The word فَبَشِّرْهُمْ, you find it in the Quran, wherever you find. فَبَشِّرْهُمْ is being used and it's meant by punishment. Then you underline this as what? تَقْرِيعَ مَا مَعَنْ تَقْرِيعَ That the glad tidings here is not good news. It's going to be what? It's going to be something that's going to hurt them. Allah says, فَبَشِّرْهُمْ Give them tidings of what? بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ أي مُؤْلِمٍ A punishment. عَذَاب Which is severe. A عَذَاب Which is painful punishment. That's what they're going to receive. Who is the exception here? إِلَّا الَّذِينَ This is استثناء متصل. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Except those who believed in Allah. وَعَامِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And they came with what? Righteous deeds. The qa'idah is that آمَنُوا and وَعَامِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ is what? Is عَطْفُ الْخَاصِ عَلَى الْعَامِ Because عَمَل صَالِح is part of iman. But Allah is taking it out because of its importance. Don't ever think to yourself iman can exist without no actions. A person has to come with actions or there's no iman. So إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا iman وَعَامِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And righteous deed here means what? It means that it's in accordance to the sunnah and it's done with sincerity. It's in accordance to the sunnah and it's done with sincerity. Lahum for those people is ajrun, a reward. غَيْرُ مَمْنُون They're going to receive and they're going to be given deeds for them is a reward that is مَمْنُون which is uninterrupted, which is دَائِم, consistent. Never will it be stopped. No one's going to interrupt it. This is just going on. It will never stop. It will forever be for them. But pay attention here, brothers. Allah never told us what the reward is. And the scholars, they say, إِبْهَامُ الْأَجْرِ The fact that the reward is concealed, دَلَالَ It's an indication عَلَىٰ عِظَمِهَا How great it is. Because you know when a king says to you, don't worry, I'm going to give you a gift. Huh? The king of the country says, I'm going to do you good. It's not like Dar es Salaam saying to him, I'm going to do you good. Huh? Sahih? It's a different story, right? فَمَا بَالُكَ بِاللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى Allah has a supreme example. But when Allah says to you, I'm going to reward you, then that means this reward is going to be what? It's going to be great. Allah mentions it in Surah An-Nisa the same. وَمَنْ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ مُهَاجِرًا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ يُدْرِكُهُ الْمَوْتُ فَقَدْ وَقَعَ أَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ His reward has fallen to Allah. I mean, Allah is going to give him reward. Hey, what reward? How? Famous hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا أَوْ امْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ Have you guys pondered on that hadith? Allah did not repeat The people who've traveled for the dunya. You know that famous hadith? It's a person who travels for the world or marriage. Look what Allah said. When he said, فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ Anyone whose hijrah is to Allah and his messenger, then his hijrah is to who? Allah and his messenger was repeated again. But when it came to the dunya, look what Allah said. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ It should have been, فَهِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا أَوْ امْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا It wasn't repeated. Ibn Rajab here, he brings a left to Latifa. What does he say? لَمْ يُذْكَرْ لِحَقَارَتِهَا It wasn't repeated because it's so low. Allah did not repeat it again. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهِجْرَةُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ His hijrah is whatever he traveled towards. The dunya, right? It's nothing. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ